But Brandon, let's move on into our next topic. And we're going from the Big 12 to the ACC now. And the one thing I thought of coming into this week, there are two teams that we haven't talked about. One team did really well when we talked about their preview. That was the Miami Hurricanes. Another team you seem to love to pick as of recent weeks when we get to our weekly picks, and that is the North Carolina State Wolfpack.
So, except for this past week.
Did you pick Louisville this week?
I did.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure I did.
I never go against Lamar Action Jackson. I will ride or die with Lamar Action Jackson. But what we're going to do is we're going to talk about these two teams, but kind of pull in a team where this fan base loves to kind of hate our picks on the teams, because Ricky likes to pick Louisville, and I can't remember who else I picked to beat them.
I'm going to step away for a minute and say special. It's not necessarily us then. It sounds like it's more you.
Yeah, it's me. It's me. I love to hate on the Clemson Tigers. And what we are looking at today is Clemson, clear favorites in the ACC. Number two in the whole college football. Number one, some people believe they should be number one over Alabama. Still think you're smoking if you believe that. But hey, we're entitled to our own opinions. Here's what we're talking about today, Brandon, and I will ask you this. Who has the better chance to upset the Clemson Tigers, if any? Just out of the two, who has the better chance? Not necessarily if they will. The 4-0 Miami Hurricanes, who got a solid last-second win over the Florida State Seminoles in Tallahassee, or the 5-1 NC State Wolfpack, who have beaten Florida State, who have beaten Louisville on the year. Their only loss is at a bullshit loss, I will say, to South Carolina, because that was a first down they got. Would have extended the drive. They would have tied the game, gone into overtime, and then anything would have happened. They should be 6-0 on the year. I will say that, and I will defend you, Wolfpack fans. Who has the better chance?
Are you upset about it?
I am very upset. I am very upset about that week one game. I remember where I was watching that game, because that was the week I went to Wisconsin to visit a friend. But who has the better chance to upset Clemson, Miami or NC State?
Well, you know, coming into this, I would have said, coming into the week, if you would have asked me, I think I probably would have said, oh, well, definitely Miami. But I think that it's after seeing this game that NC State played against Louisville last week. They both have to be in the conversation. So clearly we have them there. For NC State, it kind of goes back to game one didn't end the way they wanted it to. Kind of a clunker way to end it. But then they play a DeAndre Francois-less
Florida State
Seminole team. And they get the win. I mean, that's a hard-fought win that they got right there. And then you also then have to look at this Louisville game. And that's such a big game to take a look at. You put up 39 points. You only give up 25. You only give up 25 points. And you pretty much give up those points to Lamar Jackson himself. That's what NC State has been able to do a good job of this year. They've been able to limit those teams that usually should be able to score points like that, and they've been able to limit them. That's why they have been winning, because they've been holding down those teams that are supposed to score those big points, and they've been able to get those wins. They've been able to defensively kind of zero in on the guy or the playmaker and limit them. They still get theirs in a sense, but they've limited them. They've taken away the other weapons. If there was no Lamar Jackson, there may have not been a score for Louisville. That's a bit of a hyperbole and a bit of a stretch there. But at the same time, just take a look at that. Take a look at that game. Take a look at everything that Lamar Jackson did. Take that all away. Who else is producing? And that's a great job that NC State's able to do, is zero in, like I said, on those key playmakers and take them out of the game. Then when you jump over to Miami, I mean, out of the 30 points that they allowed in the middle of the, I shouldn't say the middle of the season, but the middle of the first half when they played Toledo, and that's all they gave up there. And they still won 30 points. Then they still win 52-30, 6 to Duke. And then 20 points to, again, a Florida State team that doesn't have DeAndre Francois. This Miami Hurricane team is stingy defensively. They really can bring it offensively. Mark Richt and this team are really very good. He's got them playing very well. I wouldn't want to go up against either one of them. That's basically what I'm saying. When it comes down to it, though, I think the team that I would be more afraid to come up against or go up against when it comes down to defense of what I've seen so far, it's NC State. It's NC State. Now, will Miami probably be able to put up more points? Probably. But defensively, I'm going to take NC State for that one.
Well, and that's kind of the reason why I am leaning slightly towards NC State. And the one thing I forgot to say before I asked you the question, and I know someone's probably commented about this up until now, this is all under the hypothetical of Miami and Clemson are meeting in the ACC title game. That's the hypothetical for here, because Clemson's not on the schedule for Miami. The only way they would meet is if Miami wins the division, Clemson wins the division. So that's the hypothetical we're using for this, where as NC State, they play Clemson November 4th at, well, NC State's, it's going to be a home game. And that to me is why, that's part of the reason why I'm slightly leaning towards NC State for two reasons. Number one, you hit it on the head defensively. The most points you've ever given up in a win, 25 points. And one of those 25 was to probably the best athlete in college football. Didn't say best player, didn't say best quarterback, say best athlete, Lamar Action Jackson. You only let them get 25 points in that game. You put up 39 against Louisville. And I know Clemson has a better defense than Louisville does, but that's still pretty impressive. However, on the other side, you look at Miami, and I know the big thing that people are going to say when it comes to these two teams. NC State, easy winner. They've played two ranked teams, gotten the win, although both teams have played Florida State, and that's one of NC State's wins. And when you look at the scores, eerily similar. 27-21 for NC State over the Seminoles, 24-20. Over the Seminoles for the Hurricanes, both of them playing without DeAndre Francois in that game, and they had very similar results. However, you look at the rest of the schedule for Miami, Duke was a non-factor, Toledo is an opponent no one's going to respect, no one's going to respect Bethune-Cookman that you beat 41-13. However, as we get through the season, show me what you got this week against 2-0, Georgia Tech. Show me what you got against right now number 15 Virginia Tech on the 4th. That's going to be a big weekend. November 4th, you get Miami at home against Virginia Tech on one side of the ACC. You get Clemson going into NC State on the other. That is going to be a huge weekend, especially for the ACC. Even show me what you got against Notre Dame. I know Notre Dame's not officially an ACC school, but show me what you got there. Miami could be a team that by the time they play Clemson, they've got some things cooking. And the only reason why I'm leaning towards NC State right now is where the game would be played. I will give a team that is playing Clemson in their home stadium with their home fans a better edge, because the only way Miami's playing playing Clemson is if it's in a neutral stadium in the ACC title game. And that is not the same as playing Clemson in your home stadium.
You know, when I take a look at this schedule and again, look at some of the games that NC State has played, and NC State has really kind of come out, and I shouldn't necessarily say surprised, because I feel like some people really did believe that this team would be this good, at least so far to start the season. But I don't know if people had the expectations then to be able to say, okay, wow, is NC State actually going to be able to hang with Clemson? Is that defense for NC State going to be this good? And I like the point that you made. You know, I think we know what we're going to get this weekend when they go on the road to Pitt. But how's it going to be when they go on the road to Notre Dame? A Notre Dame team that's now ranked 16 that looks a lot better, leaps and bounds better from what they looked last season. You're talking
about NC State going up against Notre Dame, right?
Didn't I say that? Okay,
but I was just making sure because I had talked about Miami going up. Just
clarifying. NC State, yeah, okay. Talking with that. It's going to be interesting to see how they'll do in the test that they'll get the week before Clemson. I actually think that this is the best way to do I shouldn't say the best way to do it, but this is how you want to do it. It's not like you're choosing to do this.
You're not playing cupcakes before
game. You're not playing a team that's going to – you're not going to get up for it. You're going to get up for on the road at Notre Dame. You're going to stay up for home against Clemson. Home against Clemson, that's going to be huge. That is why it's so important that they have that Notre Dame game, honestly, right before, the week right before the Clemson game. We've talked before on here, we talked just a couple of weeks ago, where sometimes teams' energy level is, and if you're down here, you're playing down to competition, and then you have to get up for another one, sometimes it just doesn't happen. So to be able to have to get up for a game and then stay up the next week, knowing you've got back-to-back games, very crucial games for you, you know, Notre Dame, and then in the ACC, Clemson, those are very big games. Those are games that you're definitely going to want to be up for. And I think that the defense already has showed a whole lot. I mean, you know, Florida State, the reason why I'm kind of like, it's you're almost in shock. And I know Florida State, again, is without DeAndre Francois, but
that
Florida State Seminole offense was supposed to be really explosive. They were supposed to be really explosive and supposed to have this sound defense, which they still still have a sound defense, but the offense has not been explosive. And then Louisville. We know what Louisville's offense can do, and they couldn't do it. NC State put up 39 then against Louisville. So the NC State's coming out. They're really putting, you know, a lot of people who hated on them or a lot of people who didn't even have them in their sights, they're positioning themselves in a really good spot. They're ranked number 20 right now in the rankings. They've done themselves a really, really good job, but you also can't count out then the Miami Hurricanes and not say the great things that they've done so far to start this season and everything that it's not only what they've done, but it's what they've been through. In back-to-back weeks, Ricky, where they had a game canceled and a game postponed, they've won then those three straight games after that. And sometimes that's tough. You play a game, then you're off for 2 weeks. You're into that groove, that season groove, and then boom, you have to be out of it for 2 weeks because of hurricane disasters and everything like that.
Two games. And you had the Arkansas State one canceled, yeah, and then the postponement, and then the postponement of
Florida State. And then you come out and you win your next three games. So for Miami to be able to do that, that's really big.
Well, and the thing that I kind of want to look up right now just to – because the thing that I think is going to win the game for either of these two teams, if you need to upset Clemson, there's one statistic that you need to win, and that's the turnover battle. You need to limit your turnovers, but also you have to not – you have to limit your turnovers and you have to force – Clemson to give the ball up, which this year seems really hard. We saw Louisville play Clemson, and the thing that killed them was turnovers in that game. And I mean, I look at right now, I look at Rozier, only three INTs, has a similar touchdown to INT as Kenny Hill, as we talked about in the first segment. He has 11-3. 10-3 was Kenny Hill. Then you look at Ryan Finley, perfect. Alex Smith-like, 10-0. Hasn't thrown a single interception. And I know now that I've said that, the Ricky Widmer curse will creep in and he'll throw an interception this week at Pitt. But you need to win that margin. And right now, NC State, according to NCAA.com, they're tied for 17th turnover margin at just one. Whereas you look at Miami, they are also tied for 17th. So both of them sit at one. Whereas Clemson in the turnover battle, if I'm going to just look them up really quickly, is they're not even in the top 50. for turnover margin, and 50 is like less than one. So they're almost even with their turnovers. If NCAA.com is correct, you need to win that battle, though. You need to force Kelly Bryant, if he plays, unless he's injured for that game, which I don't think he will be because it's so far down the line for either both these teams, you have to win the battle. And that's another notch on the side of NC State, only because Ryan Finley has been perfect so far this year, has not thrown a single interception, has not given the ball away to the other team.
And that too is playing into it, why you're able to then have a good defense, because you've got a defense that's fresh, mm-hmm. that doesn't have to be out there all the time, that's
it's
being able
like,
to...
It's not like, fuck, you just gave the ball up, man.
And that's being able to get off the field, you know what I'm mm-hmm. saying? I think that's really, really important, is we've seen time and time again, a defense that can be so good isn't able to be because they're on the field time and time again. They can't get off the field, and then finally when they do... offensively, that's why it's so mm-hmm. important to be able to have an offense that doesn't turn the football over, because it just puts then more strain on your defense. And NC State so far this season has done a really good job of just being sound on both sides of the football.
No, and that's exactly it. And right now, just even looking at Kelly Bryant, so far, I know that he's a dual threat guy and can do it with his legs as well, but just looking at his passing numbers, 4 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, even on the year. So, I mean, if I'm NC State, if I'm Miami, how do I win that game? I win the turnover battle. Because if I win the turnover battle, that is what is going to give me the best shot to win. I'm going to use the Louisville game as an example. Defense for Louisville isn't chopped liver, but one of the reasons why they weren't able to be as successful as they were, giving the ball up, and plus I believe one of those interceptions went back for a pick six, if I'm not mistaken on that one. You guys can correct me down in the comment section. I believe one of Lamar Action Jackson's interceptions went for a pick six, but that is what you need to do. You need to win the turnover battle. You need to be able to do it, and I'm looking right now just at their turnovers against Kent State. 0 turnovers for Kent State, 1 turnover for Clemson. Against Auburn in that 14-6 win, 0 turnovers for Auburn, 2 turnovers for Clemson. So already 2 games into the year, you're a +3 with turnovers given up. Actually, -3. We'll look at it that way because that's really how it would go. You're already -3. Then after Louisville, it was that one interception that they did have. So it was only one, but it did hit them at a big spot in the game and went back for a touchdown, the 44-yard interception return. But still, through 4 games, you're 3 interceptions given up to only 1 interception and 1 turnover taken away. Boston College, okay, you got 2, but you gave up 2 as well, and that was a struggle. I don't care what Clemson fans say, that Boston College game was a struggle win because you went into the fourth quarter tied 7-7. With Boston College before blowing the door wide open. VT, probably your best game. You gave up 0 turnovers. Miraculously, you forced 3 turnovers on Josh Jackson, who doesn't turn over the ball or didn't turn over the ball heading into that game. It's why I picked Virginia Tech over Clemson. And then Wake Forest. Wake Forest has 0 turnovers. Clemson turns over the ball twice. So, I mean, if that trend continues for Clemson, I could see NC State upsetting them. I could see even Miami upsetting them. However, I think the better chance goes to NC State because, A, Finley has not thrown an interception, so he's the one I'm going to say just based off numbers has the better chance to throw less interceptions than Rozier. And, 2, it's just where it's played. The Wolfpack are going to get Clemson at home. The Hurricane would get Clemson in the ACC title game, which I looked up for this year will be in Charlotte, North Carolina. That's basically a home game for Clemson, who's in South Carolina. Their fans travel easier to North Carolina than Hurricane fans. I know the tickets are split up and Hurricane fans would get a certain amount of the tickets, but that's basically a home game. That's right in the backyard for Clemson. But before we wrap this up, move into the Big Ten, any final thoughts on which team could better has a better chance to upset Clemson this year?
Nope. I'm good.
This is where we turn the conversation on to you, like we haven't already. We expect you guys to comment while we're talking, but this is where I officially turn on to you guys. Who do you think has the better chance to upset Clemson, if any? And also, do you think either Miami or NC State will upset Clemson? Because Clemson right now, undefeated. A lot of people think they're number one. We even talked about last week, are we headed towards an Alabama-Clemson part three, which would mean undefeated national championship for them. So let us know what you guys think down below in the comment section.